所以平常你都是在这边买吗？
对，我是走路上班，走路上班。
好，那如果在这边都会处理什么样的公务呢？
视讯是最常在这边的，
视讯，
因为这边有一个白墙嘛，比较容易具备。然后大概一大早，大概就是跟美洲，然后傍晚的时候回来这边跟欧洲跟非洲视讯。
哇，好酷哦
！International stage，
你的 time zone 跨来跨去。
That's right。然后就很多人问我说，什么穿日整风才是什么意思？因为那个 frame
对对对对对，超级版，穿日整风才。
OK， 那我们今天想说可以邀请。会一起跟我们开箱设计的产品，那我们待会先一起讲到
我们开始。OK， 好。
跟我觉得，就是唐凤在网络上面的影片，如果有十支的话，有五支里面会出现这个template。对，我待会用不到，但我还没有做，所以我现在趁这个空来做一下。好，那我们就坐下来。
那第一个，美劳教室，
一的美劳教室。你会不会看自己看得很烦啊？
还好不会啊，
真的吗？就是每个人都要用这个梗这样子，
没问题啊，没问题。
我还有在网络上面看 tutorial，
你要看教学影片？
对，我有看教学影片。
天佛有 origami，
origami， 只是感觉好像应该不会很难吧？就是弄什么框框的。
对啊，基本上。
怎么
办？
还要组成头型这样子。
对。
那你要粘起来。
两手
打造，不用。我是刚刚
稍微很容易抓。
对对对对对。
很清楚，
稍微抓一下。
然后是我。
那个三五，
然后再把上面合起来。
还有重点是那样一个那个。
对。
对。
其实它这个做的话，好像听说是，如果下面有垫一个碗的话。会最好，
会比较
有
比较
有
用。哎，等一下，就是如果
你这样就变一个 temple cup，
可是只是用这个嘞，
不是真正意义上的 cup，
对，
你把它当成底部。啊，你这里做的有点丑，
肉
会吗？有那种瓜皮吗
？OK 吗
？OK 了 ，OK 了，
这很小。
可以了，可以，不错不错。
这样怎么能挡得住老婆啊？你的脑袋都露在外面呢。
这个很有那种传统文化风，
有点像那种犹太帽，
小帽子，
太小了，
小帽子
太小了。我再试做一个，
傻眼，
我再做一个大一点，我头比较大。
然后我帮你补平
好。大家现在不要觉得我在浪费我们就是国家资源，他们前面都还在架设摄影机，所以本来就要等的。
对，我们是抽空，
对，
抽
空，
对，冗余时间，
对，然后，对，好，就这样子哈，
这个蛮高的吧？
哦，好，那你不要折太多，
这个比较小，
对对对对，有哎有哎有哎，
有那个对。其实重点是最后要有一个天线的感觉，
了解了解，天线宝宝，
没错没错，增幅啊，
对，
你要先收得到心才能增
幅，对，
不错不错不错，这个
好，你觉得进步很多，
有我们这网络上面没有影片是跟着唐凤一起做这个，
真的，
是不是？
没错，
得到唐凤 approve 的，
没错，
对，
嗯，
的确可以抵挡的，
嗯，
好，待会我们。
那我们等
一
下直接
现
场测试。
漂亮，对啊，我觉得折的好，
蛮好的。光线很好，反射很棒。
哎，其实我自己的方式，因为我这个折法是网络上看的，
对啊，
就自己这样折起反而还比较。
没有，所以大家现在就要看，这款是太小，傻眼。
然后再往下再把它缩小一点，对，这样 OK， 这样很好。
OK OK OK， 可以。
好，这个就是我们待会拍摄的
优质
道具。
OK， 优质的铝箔嘛，
做好了。
好。
这支影片就这样。
对。
OK， 那我们
拜拜。好，那我们现在来到拍摄空间，
没错，
待会就是要来开箱我们五个产品了。
嗯，
那我们准备好的话，我们就开始用英文了。我觉得跟唐凤讲英文真的会有一些压力，对，因为看过你很多的专访跟讲英文的时候，
所
讲的那个语速，我们今天是顺便来测试一下，我们可不可以跟得上你的语速？
对，
啊，没关系，我就把速度放慢
点。好贴心哦，
谢谢。
好，那我们就开始喽。All right, so before we jump into the unboxing, we wanted to ask first because I think a lot of the general public in Taiwan not, it's not too familiar with the concept of the so-called social enterprise.
That's right.
So how would you define social enterprises?
Sure. Social enterprise is a new kind of business that has at least two bottom line. So when we say bottom line, we usually mean the profit, right? That it has to be profitable.
Oh, right. Yeah.
But then we also mean that it has to have serve a social purpose. So purpose and profit are the two bottom lines. And also it need to be sustainable. That is to say to protect the environment so that it has also an environmental bottom line. So the social, environmental, and the economic triple bottom line are the definition of social enterprises. So such enterprises earn a profit while also taking care of the environment and also solve social problems.
Wow.
It sounds like they're in a very strict, how do you say, I'm thinking of the word bondage, but that's not the right word.
They're under a strict policy.
Right, yeah. Right. Mm-hmm. So I feel like they're under strict policies and it's harder for them to manage all three bottom lines.
Yeah, I think it's really hard.
Right. And that is why the impact-based innovation is so important, because in Taiwan, we're a very good-hearted bunch, right?
Yeah,
so if there is a, say, crowdfunding campaign where people can say, okay, if you give me this much money, maybe you will not earn it back immediately, but it will create much more social impact or environmental positive impact as compared to simply if you donate it to a charity. And so existing charities also are increasingly using this impact-driven sayings so that they can work with the general public saying, hey, we've been working on donations for a very long time. However, we also have product and services. And if you engage us with our product and services, then we can make this social purpose, this environmental purpose, much more amplified. And so that also works for the non-for-profit sector to then turn their purpose into products and services. It works both ways.
Yeah. So it's not just basing it on people's goodwill, but on an actual valid business model so that it can go on in the future and make an impact on the areas that they want to see change in. The quote you saw online, like every purchase you are shaping
the world you want to live in.
Okay.
By what I heard just now, it reminds me of a quote I saw online. I think it goes along the line of, it's shaping the world you want to live in.
That's exactly right. I mean, customers, producers, shareholders, and so on. I mean, all of it are on this us together. So, of course, all of us are seeking environmental and social impact along the way. And so creating social impact is not just the government or some charities and so on, but really in the mind of each one of us. And so I think this is a new breed of businesses, but it's increasingly becoming mainstream.
So today we're looking at five specific product lines from
social enterprises.
And let's
I think we might be able to add that into the difficulties part. Let's talk about
based on your description, if they have so many bottom lines, it seems to me if it's just purely doing business, they might have an easier time.
The rest of us have a harder time
because of
negative externalities.
But like if it's in this pattern of thinking, wouldn't social enterprises run into more difficulties when they're trying to be sustainable or even trying to survive?
That's right. And that's why in this social innovation survey done by DBS, among other people, they surveyed a lot of people in Taiwan, asking them, okay, so would you agree that a business should be having more social purpose in their bottom line?
Yeah.
And more than three quarters of them agreed.
Yeah, that's
And then a majority of of people, over 50% said they're willing to specifically, like with everything else being equivalent, to choose the products that deliver environmental and social benefits in addition to the quality of the product or services. So it all relies, as you said, on the customers. If we intentionally choose the brands that we engage with and demand accountability, like are you creating a negative or a positive environmental footprint and so on, then they, more of them will be prompted to become more social enterprises. But if we make no such choices and rely on the price alone, then of course it will create difficulties for the social entrepreneurs.
So it's a general awareness of the people, of the public, so that we are choosing the, the future.
That's right.
That we want.
We're choosing the future that we want to live in. We're choosing the future of the format of companies, of products,
that's right,
of goods and services.
Exactly.
Got it. Wow. All right. Like we just talked for a little bit, but I really feel like this is a very easy interview because we don't have to talk much.
We don't have to say anything. We're just
Audrey's
input,
making
and
most
output
of the content. Yeah,
that's right.
All right. So after our brief talk about social enterprises, let's now jump right into the five products that we will be unboxing and reviewing today.
Yeah.
Okay. 那就可以切一个，直接可以放在我们前面。
好吧。那这样，我的小超就先让路一下。
OK，
这个就先放到反正摄影机拍不到的地方，知道吗？OK， 好嘞。
哎，后面这个是要可以试试看。
可以试看。好。哇。看起来很厉害的包装。哇、有些是有东西，有些是空的。
它可能比较轻。
它可能比较轻。
比较轻。
哦，不是空的。好。
就是因为这边有三
个
不同
的
设计，所以
一
看是不是
可
以。好。哦 ，OK。没有问题，当然的。DBS 的 logo 怎么转都一样。对啊，他们怎么转那个 logo 都一模一样。
哎，
有没事？对 ，OK， 好。
可以，那五个再往
后面
添。
OK。阿迪手做 Rubik's Cube 魔术方块。OK， 好，来。
好。
好
来啊，先准备五、四、三、二。那你开始，
好，
你说 blind boxes.
Okay, so in front of us are five blind boxes, and inside each of them is one product from one social enterprise.
Right.
So today we'll be just unboxing.
Unveiling.
Yeah.
Okay.
So which one do we pick first?
I believe they all have a specific tagline to describe them.
Oh, so you mean on the box itself.
So there are five special statements to describe these products.
Okay.
So, but let's just go ahead and open one up and see what's inside. The first one, okay. 让丑小鸭也能被公平对待。So this is...
Fair treatment of ugly ducklings.
It's a jam.
格外浓品。Right, let's take a little look at the intro and see what impact it's trying to bring about.
Okay.
So here it says that 10 to 15% of farm produce, because it doesn't have...
It's out of spec.
Yeah, because it's out of spec. because it doesn't... Well, can we say that? It doesn't look as good as...
It doesn't look pretty.
Yeah, it doesn't look pretty.
Compared to the other fruits and vegetables.
That's right.
So they're taking... So instead of wasting
But the taste really good.
Yeah, the taste,
the inside... The taste is not affected. It's
not affected by the appearance.
Uh-huh.
So instead of wasting them, they're taking that fruit or produce and making them into jams. So this is... So they're trying to... So the impact that... So I feel like the impact they're trying to bring about is mainly not to waste any produce.
Like zero waste.
Zero waste.
That's right.
So, because like if you just look at this bottle, you wouldn't know that originally it was some fruit that is not as pretty.
Yeah.
It's still very pretty. That's delicious.
Except it says on the label though.
Yeah, it does say on the label.
Right.
So that's the brand.
Yeah,
that's a brand. Uh-huh. Cool. Right.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, so that's our first one. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Let's do the second number.
Let's do the second.
Okay. And this is really light.
There's nothing inside.
It's almost empty, but not. Okay, so yeah, it's really lightweight.
Oh.
It's a toothbrush.
Toothbrush.
Yeah.
Maybe like an eco-friendly toothbrush that's made of, I don't know, natural...
Yeah, it says natural bamboo.
Bamboo, all right.
That's right. It's called a good day.
Uh-huh. 好日子.
Good day.
Mm-hmm.
So here it says that they're trying to reduce plastic waste.
Uh-huh.
So the most amount of plastic waste actually comes from our toothbrushes that we use every single day. And by using bamboo and plant-based bristles, they are reducing the waste from our everyday products.
Okay.
So no plastic waste anymore.
I would be interested in this one
because
it's a very easy way to reduce plastic waste.
That's right.
Yeah, it's you know, everyday life. Like every morning, every night, you brush your teeth and you're actually reducing plastic.
Yeah,
exactly.
You feel good about yourself.
Yeah. It's little steps, baby steps, but at least you're doing something.
That's right. Yeah, that's circular economy right there.
Yeah.
Pretty good.
Okay, that's
the bamboo toothbrush. Okay. Second one. And going on to the third one. Okay, pretty heavy as well. Let's see. Oh, it's...
What's that?
Dishwashing liquid.
Okay.
Tea seed dishwashing liquid.
Okay.
Wow, the package is really good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The package is so
very pretty. Nicely designed.
It looks like just another regular product.
Yeah.
I think this is the charm of social enterprise products because it looks and feels and maybe costs around about as much as regular products.
But it has a great story to tell you.
Right, behind it, there's a purpose. Uh-huh.
So this is actually, detergent is actually extracted from tea seed oil. And it's a natural detergent, so it allows you to clean your dishes properly, but without hurting your hands.
But what's the problem that it's trying to solve? Because this can be from anything.
Exactly.
It says that originally it says that the owner wanted to protect his wife.
No, not that one.
No, not that one.
Yeah. The original story.
Yeah, probably this one. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
So it's to revitalize the economy.
So the original agenda of this enterprise is to rejuvenate their community because a lot of tea seed industry people are.
They're going off to do other things because people do not generally recognize tea seeds as viable as a detergent anymore. People have switched to use more chemical detergents and so on. And so basically by reminding people that these actually works equally or even better as a detergent, they're trying to make sure that people who are used to this like hundreds of years of traditions can find apprentices, can continue their cultures in that particular county, and because of that, it can revitalize the local economy rather than just having it dissipate and disappear.
I think preserving the culture is a big hit here.
Oh yeah, the
because
tradition.
Without the money coming in buying these products, there's no flow of economy. There won't be young apprentices coming in and learning all the practices and the traditions from maybe the last generation.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Yeah, so it's more of a culture thing, and also about placemaking.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right. Next one.
你刚刚是你开的吗？
对。
问你好了。
Right, this one. Oh, okay. Soy milk. Hey, I know this brand.
You know this brand?
Yeah, this is from, I think, Ganle.
Ganle Wenchuang. Right, that's right.
It's a brand
created by Ganle Wenchuang called Henai Chuan.
Yes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I interviewed the founder 2 years ago. I remember correctly, they're trying to revive the Sanxia community because they needed, like, the kids there need a place to stay after school, and the young people there need work. So they're creating job opportunities by making quality product, quality soy milk.
Right, so it's another place making effort.
Yeah.
Cool.
And I highly recommend this soy milk because I really love soy milk.
Have you had it?
Yeah. Okay. Last time I went, they treated me to like two big bottles. I finished it in within 3-4 days.
Okay.
It's really good. It's thick and it's creamier than regular soy milk.
Are you going to drink it on cam?
Camera? Right now? Can we? Are we allowed to drink?
Of course, why not?
Bottle is so cute.
Yeah, it's ice too.
They produce it in bigger bottles as well. Last time they gave me big bottles.
Yeah, I think it's also a tourism factory, so you can actually go there and see it being made.
Yeah, it's really good. Yeah. And you won't like it because there's no sugar.
It's no sugar. Yeah, I saw it. No sugar, right on the brand. I saw it.
Okay.
For our last piece.
Mm-hmm. Last piece is.
Okay.
Oh, I know this.
Oh,
it's from Pure Milk. Yeah, it's from Shen Ru Fang. Mm-hmm. Okay, so actually, my boba tea shop also uses this milk.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, all of our milk is from Shen Ru Fang.
And why do you use this shop?
I think their purpose is really good. Mm-hmm. And this enterprise, they are special for having professional animal doctors on all their ranches.
Okay.
So this social enterprise is special for having professional animal doctors on their ranches.
Mm.
So their cows are really taken care of.
Mm.
All they want is for their cows to be happy. Yes, that's their sole purpose, to have happy cows and then to have high quality and good milk.
Mm-hmm.
So by making good milk, they make their customers feel safe about the product they're using, they're drinking, and that creates a really healthy cycle.
Cool.
So they produce healthy and good milk, and then that helps the enterprise to continue on the mission.
That's awesome.
How much are they paying you to say this?
No.
Is it because they're your supplier?
No. But
You spend 10 times the amount of time talking about this milk compared to the rest of the product.
No, it's because I know this product, so why not use the advantage and promote them a little bit.
And do you like the flavor?
I do.
Would you like to drink it?
Oh, sure. It's like a...
Is it a tasting?
We have our own...
Yeah.
This is good. I have my own flavor, the sugar soy milk.
So maybe tampon.
Of course. Eat it raw? Why not? It'll be too sweet.
Yeah.
It's this great taste right there.
Great taste.
Yeah. Okay.
Yep.
It's good.
It's really good.
That's awesome. Yeah, so a lot of the work that DBS and my office has been working on is just to making sure the social enterprise products are not a one-off thing. Like, so instead of just hearing about it, trying once, and then forgetting about it, we're trying to convince business owners, such as you, to integrate their supply chain with social enterprises so that this purchase will be ongoing. And also, it gives people more opportunity to learn about their purposes.
Yeah. And through this video as well, we're learning about 5 great products that can be reused, rebought, and just basically brought into your life.
Exactly right.
Okay. So let's put them in order.
Okay.
All right. Okay, so for the final bit, we're going to go into our competition.
Oh, my gosh.
What's the competition?
The competition is... Oh, you didn't know about this?
No idea. Completely no idea.
So we have 5 products, and we just read their intros and talked about them a little bit.
That's right.
Now we're going to draw from a lottery box.
Okay.
And whatever we draw, we will have 10 seconds to prepare. and 20 seconds to speak.
We have
to fit in as many English words into that 20 second time frame as possible.
Okay.
And we'll compete to see who can speak English in the shortest amount, who can speak the most English in the shortest amount of time.
Ah, okay, I had no idea. I'm happy to be the referee.
The whole point of this video is us against you.
I see, okay. All right, let's get started.
All right, so let's draw the lots.
Okay.
Okay, maybe you can go first.
Okay, this one? So just 3 out of 5.
Yeah, just 3 out of 5.
Okay.
Okay.
Wow.
Wait, hold on. That's to be fair.
Okay.
We can only prepare for 10 seconds and then speak for 20 seconds.
So when it's our turn, we can.
Yeah, when it's your turn, open it up.
Okay.
Yeah. So let's. Who should go first?
I have no idea.
Maybe
I should.
Maybe.
Okay. Yeah. Of course. Why not? Okay, so who will count to 10 for me?
Oh, wait, we have to have a timer. And
yeah, we have a timer.
Should we record it down?
We'll record whatever you say, and then we'll after we type it out, we'll count the words, how many words you said.
Okay, so
I might need a computer.
So the idea is that I take this and I choose the product corresponding to it, and I read about it for like 10 seconds, and then I talk to the can for 20.
Okay, sure.
So
whichever one it is, you don't necessarily have to read
everything.
What's here. Uh-huh. You can just
say whatever.
Say whatever. Okay. Describing.
Sure, why not?
I need a computer.
Help.
Mm-hmm.
You can look at it for a little bit.
No, it's fine.
Can I look at it?
No, of course you can't.
No, it's fine.
You 们这里面是写它的
品相。
品相哦，两个都有写。OK。
嗯。好啊，
对，对，
好啊，
我先录下来，等下，那我们可以先录。
电脑不会入境吗？
电脑不会入境。
Okay.
对，我是要在境外打，然后算。
OK, I see.
OK, 那我们其实可以先录。
好。
对啊，因为反正会录下来，你打字之后重播就好了。
对，我这边会录下来。
对 ，OK, 好，说开我就开。
3, 2, 1,
action. Okay. Okay. All right. Let's see. All right. So this is about the out of spec 格外农品 and I get to read about this for 10 seconds. Okay. Let me know when the time's up. Okay.
Okay. 等一下要 time for 20, 所以你先归零之后。然后
你要用倒数的那个，不是用码表的那个。
对对对，用倒数。
对，
倒数20秒。Okay, so 3, 2, 1.
Hello, this is Audrey Tang. I'm happy to introduce the green Ponggan jam from this Ge Wai Nong Pi Goodwill Foods. What they do is that they take out-of-spec agricultural products and make extraordinary, exceptional out-of-spec jams out of it. And as you can see here in their logo, it doesn't matter whether it looks a little bit spotted, it's a little bit large or short or whatever. Okay.
Okay.
That was... That was
pretty fast.
That was very fast.
That was a lot of words.
That was a lot of words.
I wasn't trying.
好，那我们都先录完好了。我们都先录完之后，然后再。Okay, next.
See?
Yeah.
I'm so nervous. I didn't sign up for this.
No, I didn't.
Originally, it was only the two of you.
Okay.
But then.He had to drag me down.
Okay.
Oh!
Okay, well, your favorite.
Hey, my favorite!
Your thing, it's your thing.
Okay, wait.
It's your thing. You get to read about
more
it.
More the pressure. More the pressure.
Okay.
Pass out.
Alright.
Okay.
Alright.
好，二十秒。
等一下，你要等他设定。
Okay. Stop. Okay.
Oh, no. Wait. I need to.
Okay.
Okay.
好。
三。Okay. 3, 2, 1.
Okay. So this is a product, from the social enterprise 鲜乳坊, and its main goal is to produce, good milk. What's so special about them is that they have professional animal doctors on site overlooking the production of milk and the health of the cows.
No! You had a really big pause in between.
I know. I was trying to figure out my priority.
Okay.
Oh no!
All right. Yeah. Next up, it's me.
Okay.
Let's see what I got.
Soy milk.
What?
It's exactly what we had today.
That's
great. Jack will all drink
no,
soy
this,
milk.
No, this is not set up at all.
Yeah, we did not set it up.
We did not set it up. Just like Yifang Jun, this is completely fair.
Okay. Okay.
3, 2, 1.
All right.
Okay.
Right.
Wait, hold on. Okay. Right.
3, 2, 1.
All right. I love soy milk. This soy milk tastes so good. It's thicker and creamier than regular soy milk on the market. And there's a story behind the people that's working on this project, because they're trying to rejuvenate their community by bringing in more job opportunities, mm-hmm. and trying to sustain and support the community and the families that live there.
Okay, pretty
okay.
good. Awesome.
I think I did okay.
Yeah, you did awesome.
All right. Yeah. All right, let's see.
Let's celebrate.
Let's count the words. Let's celebrate, yay!
Woo! Okay.
Such a coincidence.
Yeah,
and
we got our respective goods.
Yeah.
Wait, we have to like...
And I tasted this before, actually. I really like
it. We have to prove that we did everything.
Yeah, it's not rigged.
Yeah,
it's not rigged.
It's not rigged.
We have all five products
That's right. Right, the other one is really
down.
A good day.
Calm down, you're tearing the sheet.
All right, see?
And the other one is really
the TC. The and the
good day. Okay.
Great.
Excellent.
Okay, so we need...
Let's count the words.
And do I actually drink this? How does it even work?
Take drinking the jam.
It tastes really good, actually.
Really? Not too sweet for you?
It's, of course, very densely packed.
Okay, so 3, 2, 1. Hello, this is Audrey Tang. I'm happy to introduce the green Tonggan Jam from this Pilwen of Goodwill Foods.
How did this go?
And Nong Ping. Goodwill Foods.
What they do is that they take out of spec products. And make exceptional out of spec jams.
out of it.
Out of it.
As we see here. It doesn't matter whether it looks a little bit small, it is a little bit large, or short, or whatever.
It
looks a little bit spotted, a little bit larger, or shorter. I think I got to shorter.
Okay.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
Huh.
Okay, so.
63个字, 格外农品算一个。
What they do is that they take out of spec agricultural products.
Agricultural products.
It doesn't matter whether it looks a little
wetter, yeah.
Whether
it looks
a little bit spotted, it's a little bit large or short, or
okay. I think it's good.
A little bit larger or shorter.
Yeah.
Okay,
it's good.
Okay.
Alright.
So
that's 67 words.
How do you know? Oh, here. I was like, did you count?
You counted it!
No, like the funny thing is, I didn't doubt that he counted.
That's right.
It would be reasonable.
No, it would be reasonable, but word counts, it's easier.
Okay, next is, so here, 67 words.
Mm-hmm.
Next.
Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Okay, so this is a product from.
What's so special about that?
That they have professional animal doctors on.
Professional animal doctors
on the ranch.
On site.
Overlooking the production of milk.
And the health of the cows.
Okay. Oh, that's it?
Yeah, that's it.
Hey, respect!
This is 49 words.
Okay.
Yeah, let me.
3, 2, 1.
Okay, so this is a product. From the social enterprise Xian Wu Fang, and its main goal is to produce good milk. Wait is not a word.
You cannot count fillers.
Okay.
Otherwise, you'll just keep saying wait. And then you get 200 words.
Okay.
Good milk. What's so special about them is that they have professional animal doctors on site overlooking the production of milk and the health of the cows.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, that's
so
fair.
So that's, let me see how many words. So that's 47 words.
What?
Without the weight.
And the weight.
Yeah, without the weight.
Okay.
Okay, next is mine.
It's me. Let's see what I've got. Okay. All right. I love soy milk.
That's a really good opening, by the way.
That's so funny. I love soy milk.
It tastes so good. It's thick.
It tastes so good.
A great follow up. It's so thick.
And creamier than regular soy milk.
Thicker and creamier than regular soy milk.
On the market. There's a story behind the people. That's working on this project. Because they're trying to rejuvenate their community by bringing in more job opportunities. And trying to sustain and support the community and the families that live there.
I think you've got more words than I do. Let's see here.
It's four full lines.
57.
Except you use longer words.
Oh, dude.
Like opportunities, rejuvenating.
The community.
Yeah.
If it's complete, then that's 60 words.
Yeah.
60 words.
Yeah.
Okay.
But you see, the line is longer.
All right. So after summarizing and having the transcript out, Audrey scored 67 words.
Shorter words, but okay.
Crown scored 47 words. And I scored 60 words. Yeah. I think we all did a pretty good job, except maybe Crown.
Thanks a lot.
No, I think it's mostly the pause,
yeah,
the long pause that you did. Yeah.
I was like thinking, what should I go for next?
You know, I have the perfect thing for you. You should have worn this.
And amplify.
Yeah, this is what you should have worn, all right? So
okay.
This is your reward.
Okay, thank you.
All right. 文字档可以再传给我吗？ 之后再传给我, 因为它刚好就是...
好,
okay,
所以这一趴就这样,
好, 那我们把这个, 这个应该, 诶, 应该也是放在我们这边,
把它喝完吧, okay, 我做不到, 我做不到,
危险, 危险,
对,
这个直接放，这个直接不要放，就放在下面就好了。好，然后接下来我们就都是用中文讲，然后讲一些新单词去的。那我还是要小尝试，再尝给我。哎呦，哎呀，这应该还算自然吧？可以，可以。那个商品要稍微后退一点，它会，然后之后上次我的。OK。嗯。这样可以吗？牙刷可以在后面。
可以了，好，这样子OK。好，来，三二一，开始。好的，我们结束了。我觉得松了一口气，
。我每次这种比赛，就至少不要最后一名就好了。哈哈哈哈哈！就是觉得要拉一个后面的垫底的人，所以他就找我了。我觉得今天聊的是更深入的了解到社会企业到底是什么样子的代表，以及他们在做产品、在做商业模式的时候，想要造成社会上面什么样子的影响，特别是今天的这五家，他们背后都有一个想要解决的问题，
对，
而且是你可以每一天想象是，而且是可以回购的，它是可以延续在你生活当中，有这个消费行为。 然后接下来，那接下来我们要讲什么吗？就是讲说，就是你可以讲说，那刚刚其实社会企业，你可以讲切入点，其实我刚接着讲说，其实社会企业很需要解决的一个，也就是大家对他们的曝光跟他们的认识。就像我们刚刚有讲到这个 survey， 其实最后其实只有30%的人有听过社会企业。对啦，对对对。好，OK，好，那所以呢，这个我就直接接你刚刚那句，对。
确实啊，其实我们这么几年来，不管是信贷银行跟我们台新院啊，这个联合报业景工程啊等等一起做的就是社会企业相关的一个调查，都显示说，其实只要认知到社会企业的人，那其实就刚刚讲的 75% 都非常认同，就是这是一件好事，而且越来越多人是觉得，哎，那如果这个真的讲得出来，像刚刚说，哎，他对一个特定的地方的创生，或者说他对一个永续的循环有什么理念的话，不但是你会购买 这个产品，而且就会像弟妹一样，碰到人就会来推销。这个理念就是他创业的时候也用，对，
这是很好的产品，而且他们有个很好的。 purpose， 所以才会想要去支持他们。对啦，所以这个我们就发现说，以前在国外听到
Made in Taiwan 讲的是特定的产品嘛，或特定的服务。那现在 Made in Taiwan 越来越多就是一种创新的模式，就是哦，原来兽医师也可以这样子去开一家牧场等等的这种做法。那这样子的做法，其实只要能够扩散开来，就越来越多人在创业的时候也可以把这种社会意识带到他的创业理念里面。所以我觉得这里面是非常重要的。
OK，好，然后再来，
好，这一段我们有讲到，
对，真的讲到了，然后，OK，来，好，然后接下来这个，如果说，但是这边我想一下，这边，对，好，好，那最后问一下说，那这个，
好，
我觉得你可能还是需要一张小卡，因为不然新展的 logo 出不来，哦，这个很。
很空，对，或者
用后置上，
还是没有了，还是那个那个产品的盒子，对啊，对啊，对啊，对啊，刚才我们注意到，我们不管怎么转，这个 logo 都一样。
那不然我知道了，我知道了，我知道了。那我刚刚彤彤讲完那一段，然后我就接着问，那星展银行跟这些社会企业的关系是什么？它是怎么样帮助这些社会企业？然后他们就可以继续往下讲，
好吗？
这样子 ，OK
哈。
好，那你那时候就可以再拿出，你可以不用拿。
好。
那星展银行跟这些社会企业他们的关系会是什么？
对，我们可以看到说，就是这几家其实都是星展帮忙倡议，就是去把他们的这个理念去让更多人知道，然后培育，就是去确保说，诶，他在营运的过程里面需要一些辅导啊等等。那星展其实不是只是出钱而已，还出力。星展里面的很多的高阶经理人都自己去担任这些社会企业的业师，去告诉他们说，诶，怎么样经营才能够让市场更了解他们的价值，以及所谓的整合。整合的意思就是说，星展自己内部的企业的活动啊，这些都会使用这些社会企业的产品，因为我连续好几年有参加他们的活动，当然也很感谢他们赞助我们这边的社会企业高峰会等等活动，我们就会发现说，诶，真的耶，他们是随时随地你到走进他们的摊位，在他们的公司里面就会看到这些社会企业的产品跟服务在他们日常生活当中，所以我觉得这真的是很好，就是说他让这些社会企业也能够改变星展的人的文化，不是只是说好像星展往外推销，他也往内去更加理解这些社会部门跟环境部门这些想要做事情的人的想法。
你好像不用呼吸耶、欸、
我在逗号的时候欢喜
你刚讲的好长一串好厉害、
对，
那这样听起来星展真的是一个在社企的很大的推手、
对，
因为其实说真的你要讲一个理念很值得敬佩，你要讲社会公益大家应该都要参与，但是讲归讲真的身体力行的人都还是少数、
没错，我想社会企业的一个特色啦，就是说它这个理念你每天稍微喝一点这个鲜乳坊加冕鲜乳，或者是喝奶川，或者是用这个洗什么盘子啊，或者是用这个果酱啊，这个牙刷啊等等，就是说每一天每一天你在做的时候，第一个你会想到说，诶，我正在帮助这个地方的朋友们，另外一个就是这些地方朋友，诶，如果有什么新的创新，有什么新的做法，诶，他也可以帮助你啊，因为这个时候你去跟你的朋友去呼朋引伴，想要去哪边玩啊，或者是说想要去更加了解哪一个地方的时候，你去那边就不是走马看花而已，你就完全知道说，你去那边你要去看哪里，
你
要去他的斗志所，对，你会有参与感。
像这个是甘乐文创，手去拜访之后，我也有就是资助他们的那个小草书房，
对，
然后他们就会定期寄过来一些期刊，说我们又做了什么，我们又辅导了多少小朋友，然后就会觉得啊很有参与感，我参加了一个，虽然说我做的事情很微薄，就我只是可能捐一些钱跟买他们的产品，但是他们在身体力行做这些公益的事情，会让我有一种我参与在里面。
对，
对，好，
应该差不多了吧？
差不多了，
还有一个要讲，
台湾食物银行联合会。
今天开箱的这种日企业，大部分都是由星展基金会所支持。
社会企业奖助金，哎，这个不在这里，不在我的这个里面。
那
好啊，
刚刚讲，如果说他用字卡呈现可以吗？就是这些，
还是我们，我觉得我们业配就大方业配啊，就是就直接对着 Ken 我用讲的，所以你那一段拿过来放我这里，我就直接念一遍，然后看你要怎么缝进去了，看你要怎么缝，你可以放前面或后面。
好，
对对对，好 ，OK， 来，那我就直接讲了，就我觉得因为这个 prompt 都很奇怪，这等于 co prompt。好，那非常谢谢大家看这支影片。今天开箱的五个社会企业都是星展基金会所支持的，那绝大部分呢都是社会企业奖助金的计划的得主，那所以如果对这些想法有兴趣，而且想要知道未来星展银行还会支持哪些社会企业的话，也欢迎大家加入星展社会企业伸展台这个社团，除了可以一起讨论社会企业，还可以获得这五家的限时专属优惠。
然后你帮我把我们的影片结尾掉了我们不用结尾了。OK。
OK， 专业带货。
好
，OK，
好，
谢谢，谢谢，
OK， 好，那今天真的谢谢 Audrey，
谢谢，
我觉得，我自己的英文，有变好的感觉，
谢谢，
在一个强者面前，
是被阿丽这样讲，真的很荣幸，
遇强则强，
是，是，好，
然后有一个人就是带着这个 Temple Hat，
不过这个折的蛮不错的，蛮漂亮，
好，那今天很开心可以跟 Audrey 一起来拍这个开箱，那大家如同刚刚 Audrey 帮我们结尾的，如果想要了解更多社会企业在做什么的话呢，我会把这些更多我都会把相关的链接放在影片的更多资讯哦。And that's a wrap， 我们就下次影片见喽 ，See ya，See
ya， 拜拜。